In paradise, right?
Rolling, wakey wakey, edgy bakey.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live.
I've actually seen one playthrough of this.
Assholes.
I haven't played it, and it's been a while, so I'm going through it and going to be making a bunch of different choices than
was
what I saw. But I'm going to play it non-spoilery. I don't know if you've played it or not, but in case people come who haven't played it, I'm not going to spoil the big stuff.
That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real?
Creepy, faceless class photo. Warren Graham, who we know. Chloe Price. Hayden Jones, we know. Zachary Riggins, I think we know. Trevor, Logan, Alyssa. Justin Elliott, Dana Evans, Stella Brooke, Juliet, Victoria, Nathan Taylor, and Rachel Amber. Most of these characters we met in the first one, or at least know about, and a bunch of them we're going to meet or re-meet in this one.
One of these days, I'm actually going to use you to do my homework. Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town.
Miss Arcadia. That's hilarious. Let's see. Oh, so this is about how she found out about Firewalk.
Wait, what? Who? What photo?
So Victoria Chase is a total stupid biatch who, well, if you haven't played the first one, let's just say she's all up in the action. She's also obsessed and jealous with Rachel Amber because Rachel's the most popular person in White Cooler, and we'll see that more as this goes on. Here it is, selfie on the internet with Rachel Amber. She says most of them not good feelings, but we will see very soon that this is, in fact, good feelings. Rachel, Firewalk, Trevor, jealous. Victoria, you look hot. Who's the arm candy? Meaning Chloe. Armin, Deborah something? Deborah Borgen, I think? Taylor, so fun. Kisses. Dana, glam. Get it, girl. Trevor, who's Deborah Borgen? Armin, with Rachel in the picture. Juliet, great. You are so gorgeous. I hate you. Victoria, who's Armand? Trevor, dude, that's Chloe Price. Victoria, Taylor, wasn't Rachel invited to your sleepover last night? I was wondering where she was. I can't believe they're still having sleepovers. It's craziness. Steph, burn. Okay, Steph is amazing, and the actress who plays Steph is amazing. I follow her on Twitch. We'll get back to that later, but Steph is awesome. Victoria, oh no, I didn't mean it like that. So much fun. Alyssa, this is a really intelligent conversation. Yeah, Alyssa. Hipster nerd.
I'm perfectly capable of waking up without you, you know. Eventually.
Oh. Here comes the clothing decision, so I don't have the special edition. I know all the special edition clothes, so let's see what we can do.
How do I want to express my
teenage Oh, and the pirate hat.
Today.
Her and Max love being pirates. Getting dressed, yeah! Oh, wow, I really don't have any choices. I have to choose Raven. Okay. She actually looks best in the Raven, in my opinion. So let's just go for it. I mean, being a 36-year-old man, but identifying with angsty female teens, or just angsty teens in general, and like thinking getting cool t-shirts is awesome. You know, what are you going to do? It's 2018. Got to embrace it. Looking good, Chloe.
I really should get going.
Nope, we're not going yet, Chloe.
Nice one, Chloe. Mom's gonna love the new look.
I think I lost Guy in chat because I played the game already and don't have a camera. Oh well, thanks for stopping by. If I go get dressed, does it give me another option? Nope.
I really should get going. Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong, and it was awesome.
Yeah, Mom was sort of right, sort of wrong. Yeah, man, I played through the first version. Maybe twice. I love the first version. It's kind of Donnie Darko, which is a movie I love. And they reference it a lot. And the time travel mechanic is cool. But I think I like the narrative better here. I like the main relationship better here. I like playing Chloe better. And they really, I think, step up the writing. I'm actually trying to replay Life is Strange on my iPad, but freaking Square Enix released three of the five, and I paid for the freaking season pass, and they still haven't dropped. Yeah, exactly. No mess. Square Enix still hasn't dropped episodes 4 and 5 on iOS, but whatever. Whatevs. Pirate power. Oh, they love being pirates. Let's see. Mr. Sharky.
Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
I love this. Bask ye mortals in the light of the glowy bear. I think I looked at this photo already. Oh no, there's another photo with her daddy.
Dad was so proud of me.
I mean, the tragic death of her dad sets her completely on all the badness. Bad decisions and bad things that happen in her life. Oop, report card. This is not going to be good.
Man, I am killing it this year. Somehow, I don't think
we do, of course, learn that she loves science, but she's just not so good at... I am not a Twitch partner. I've actually completed all the stuff to at least be an affiliate, but I think you need to have 70 people on your stream at once, and I haven't quite gotten there yet. I've been playing Stellaris, the strategy game, and had a pretty good following on that. And I do play that on my computer so I can do camera and stuff. But I need to find the right game in the right time and get enough audience to fulfill that final goal. Any suggestions? Alright, I think I've done everything here. Umbrella's optional, folks. Alright, let's go see the shit show that is my life at home.
Shit, where's my phone?
Uh-oh.
It's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling
my mom.
Phone.
Oh, Mom.
Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out...
Home, sweet home.
Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again.
Yeah.
He just didn't want to.
Into the bathroom.
Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair's his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray.
Nope, you're not dyeing your hair gray. There's a much better color than gray, but we'll wait for that.
The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, Scourge of Arcadia
Bay. I love it. Okay. Oh, wait, can I, I thought maybe I could tag that. Okay, so I didn't spend the money on the weed, so I think I can sneak the money to Mom.
Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pond. Wait, yep. Mom's selling her engagement ring?
I've been streaming well over 3 times a week. I thought I looked at the affiliate requirements and you needed a minimum following, but I'll look again. To be honest with you, I don't really doing this now for like money, but I do have like a podcast network, and so I would love to be able to get more visibility using this. Here we go. Here's my good deed.
Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup.
Maybe not yet.
I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad.
I mean, I would be upset too as a kid, but I understand why her mom's trying to move on, and so I am actually not going to place it on the dresser.
I made this for Mom when I was, like, 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed.
So the key is, Chloe still loves her mom to death, even more since her dad died, but Step Douche, who we're gonna meet soon, is making it really hard.
Ah, Mom! Bad enough that David comes here for dinner. I think Mom's phone is in her bedroom. I should call my phone.
The old call the phone trick.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
I do know Twitch updated their terms of service recently. I don't know all the new ins and outs.
Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign.
We're gonna look at some gross stuff.
Why would I open that drawer again?
Yeah. That's nasty even if it's your dad and you love him.
It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money.
Yeah, man, I'd love the bucks. Even like, you know, $100 a month or something. I live in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. But I'm a huge night owl and pull all-nighter, so I stream at all various times. Which is cool because I get like Europeans and Australians and stuff coming in.
Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were.
Pithy platitudes.
Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. Better.
I guess I better get my phone. Where's that damn phone? No, it's around here somewhere. Oh, it's in the toilet. That's awesome.
Ugh. I drank way too much last night.
She's bragging about 5 beers. She had like 1 and she's hungover. That's hilarious. Chloe was really divisive in the original game, but when you play this game, even though it's a different voice actress, it's just hard not to love her. Mom, will you be coming home at some point tonight? Chloe, will you be home by curfew? There will be consequences. Elliot. Oh, boy, Elliot. So Warren is sort of the semi-stalker of Max, the main character in the first one. Some people liked Warren, some people hated Warren, and you have some choice as to how you deal with him. Elliot's that figure in this, although things go much differently. Spanish test sucked. Lucky if I passed. Aw. Lo siento. No, I think I did okay. Cool. What are you up to? Not much. Got shit to do later. Okay. Finished the chem. Homework? Nope. Dude, that's the third time. He's keeping track of my homework, and clearly, Chloe, we do not want to talk to you.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah. Okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Are we going back to the room for the purse? Man, this is weird to control with a console controller.
They should take that down to Mom.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah. That really makes me want to hurry.
Why are you turning me around if I have to go get... Oh, did I grab the cell phone? Hello, Firefly D. Already like you with the Firefly. I think I got the cell phone in the bag. I totally missed it because I was looking at chat. I guess I got it already. Okay, Ma, I'm coming. I am totally coming. Controls are mostly better than the first game, but it's still a little janky.
Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
All right, so this is begins a lot of choices of how you want to deal with Mom and David and their relationship and the home situation. I think I have an idea of how I'm going to approach this, even though I forget a lot of the specifics, but I will keep that a mystery.
Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
Yeah, I mean, it's not ideal, but to be honest with you, a slow-paced point-and-click game like Life is Strange, I kind of like just kicking back on my couch and just using my computer to monitor Twitch and social media and stuff, so I can deal with a little bit of janky controllers, to be honest with you. I have very mixed feelings about consoles in general. Well, I guess we're going to have to see about David. All right, so the key with point and clicks is to look at everything possible before you engage in the conversations that will inevitably move plot forward.
Haven't really felt like sitting down to eat since David started having dinner here.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out. Got Mom's purse. Still exhausted. Better not do any more good deeds today.
Wow. Sean Prescott's son, Nathan.
Oh, the Prescott's Nathan. God damn it. Have both of you guys played the first Life is Strange, so I don't spoil anything about the first one? I'm not going to spoil anything about the second one.
Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
I've seen... Okay, cool. I've seen Farewell played. I haven't played it, but I watched Dodger and Jesse Cox play it. Actually, I've seen the entire playthrough of all the games with Dodger and Jesse Cox. It's actually what got me into this game, to be honest. Wildfire.
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
I mean, Both Dodger and Jesse Cox can be a little bit of an acquired taste, but I met them a few years ago on Will Wheaton's Tabletop show on YouTube and loved them on that, and so it was a little bit easier for me to get into their kind of bizarre sense of humor. And Total Biscuit's hilarious, so I like the co-optional podcast. Like,
what the hell just happened?
I'm also around Total Biscuit and Jesse Cox's age. So we all grew up in the 80s and 90s with old school computer games and stuff, so I can relate.
Little dude's like, what the hell just happened?
Did I just shake that twice? My bad. Can I go outside?
Made that for Mom in an art class when I was like 5. She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist.
Wait, those aren't Mom's keys.
And these would be David's keys.
Well, the thing about Jesse in particular is he uploads edited versions of the best stuff he does onto YouTube. He does a lot of Let's Plays that just go on YouTube. I'm a YouTube Red subscriber. I prefer watching VODs to live streams. So I support them with subscriptions. But I mostly follow them on YouTube.
It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so nobody's fault, really.
There's the wine stain.
From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me.
We're already supporting one. Thanks.
She doesn't really respect his service, at least not yet. It just sees him as a freeloader.
Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never happened. I would have gotten this bad boy in my room.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max?
I mean, all the pirate stuff with the young Max and Chloe really comes together with Farewell, as you guys know. Let's see. I'm not a YouTube viewer. I'll stick to Twitch. Keep up the work, even if you plug other streams. Yeah, I mean, I don't really see it as plugging. Honestly, I've been following them for so long, and I really appreciate what the purely independent streamers who aren't, you know, corporate tools and are honest and funny, and so I'm all about spreading good times and entertainment.
To believe I was an eighth grade science
athlete. It's so cute and Farewell, but it's so painful because all the tragedy just washes over you and it's hard to tune it out.
Any letter from Blackwell is never good.
Nope. Here we go.
Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like, I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case.
So it's certainly implied in both games that Chloe is outcast partially because she is a scholarship kid, and most of them are just rich, spoiled kids. In Farewell, we find out for sure that she's immediately made fun of at school because of it.
Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year.
Oh, no, I am not implying you're spreading hate at all. I mean, I'm so casual at this point, I don't see it as competition. Let's see. I think I can give Mom money, but it's not letting me do it
that
right now.
Mom's purse? Still exhausted. Better not do any more good deeds today.
All right, I think it's time to talk to Mom. It's almost time to talk to Mom. Swear
Dad's
jar.
Old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
I used to be in the music industry full time, you know, but I would try and support and promote artists that I liked, and sometimes it led to collaboration, so you never know.
Mom hates pot roast.
How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth?
Nope, bacon better than sugar bombs. Sorry, Chloe.
It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
Okay, time to talk to Mom. Here we go.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
One thing I love about these games is total lack of over-exposition. There's a lot of implied backstory that you read into. Oh yeah, she's a mama. Sorry, I'll do better. I was sleeping. Some of these, I know what the responses are going to be, but I really think it's in character for Chloe that she loves her mom, so sorry, I'll do better.
Sorry. I hear you.
Oh, really? Oh, fuck.
I'll hear about replying.
Thank you.
I missed your response. Okay.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
My bad.
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Alright, so we know the plot answers here.
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't.
To be fair,
I don't hate it. And David likes
it. Joyce is a little too much of a heavy hand, a little too influenced by David's assholeness.
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons, like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then?
Ooh. David's school. Let's do school first.
Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
All right, they're not married yet.
Chloe,
I forgot that.
You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
Yep, he's a dickhole.
Old fashioned.
Yeah, an old fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight.
The interesting sort of ethical moral question is: does his heroics at the very end of the first game excuse all of the assholeness that leads up to it?
Eggs, two for David, two for me. And just before I serve them, he says, what are you gonna eat?
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that?
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you? Saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled.
Joyce is not wrong about any of these things that Chloe's doing.
Between your grades,
she doesn't understand the
rules,
underlying reasons for what's going on.
I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me.
And yeah, again, I mean, I totally support veterans and that stuff. I
just
get
let
it.
Me know so I
but
can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep
using
you on
the you don't know the shit I saw when I was in the army thing, it doesn't excuse everything, in my opinion. Maybe I just need to be left alone. Maybe David could help. Okay.
Maybe I just need to be left alone.
Maybe you're 16 and don't know what you need. David thinks you need discipline.
Discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man.
By the time you're 16, implementing more discipline is usually not the best thing.
You're
Your boyfriend's an asshole.
He's been good for me. Maybe he rubs
the thing is, if you're not going to play Chloe as totally going after David in this game, then I feel like you're not getting the full experience of the game.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet.
So my approach is try and be nice to Mom, but unload on David.
He takes you to school today.
Very funny.
Oh, yeah, during the car ride, I'm going to do my best to wreck him, but...
Are you serious?
We'll see.
This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should, too.
But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
Oh, man. So this is clearly the one response in this conversation that will change some shit. I honestly think at this point, knowing Chloe, knowing her mom, she will be understanding, at least in this moment, just to calm her mom down and just not to deal with the situation. Yeah, I agree.
Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me.
It's also the smart thing to do, even if she just wants to manipulate her mom to get off her back a little bit.
You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
I will say...
Tell that to the world.
Well...
You're impossible.
Yeah, I will say, well, I agree that this game is, you know, it's nice to just have narrative, no time travel, great writing, great animation. But I do feel like there are a number of choices in the first game that really do change the experience during the episodes themselves. Whereas this game, most of the choices are pretty straightforward. And
bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating.
There's a lot you don't want to miss out on in this, even if you feel like experimenting. Yeah, exactly. It's some of these options, it's like you're curious about, but. All right, here we go. My good deed for the day.
You're welcome.
Come on, sweetheart. I'm sure David's waiting for his keys.
Now I'm the errand boy for David with his freaking keys. Can I go into the garage here? I can't remember.
I made that ashtray for Mom's keys only. I actually have to let this jack-off drive me to school. This is my life now. Kill me. Crap. I forgot David's keys.
I mean...
That's probably worth at least 10 pushups.
The thing is, I love great movies and great dramas. And the best movies, whether they're big-budget movies or indies, succeed based on the relationships of the main character. And it's hard to deny, in my mind, that Rachel Amber and Chloe is the most compelling of the relationships. So,
crap.
Yeah.
I forgot David's keys. That's probably worth at least 10 push-ups.
David can't leave our house without his keys. I better get them to him. Stat.
Oh, Rachel's fantastic.
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going.
Yes, Steph! Best side character ever! Hey, is this Chloe? This is Steph Gingrich. Hey, I have your DVD. You can get it before school. Thanks. Steph, so cool.
What a piece of crap. The car, too.
And Katie Bentz, who voices Steph, has become a new streamer that's doing a pretty good job on Twitch, getting her thing going, actually. Very interesting character. And definitely super quirky like Steph.
No, Mom.
Oh, my God. I hate this guy.
To death with the tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Yeah, you should. She's very responsive on chat, and she plays everything from Grand Theft Auto to Fortnite to point-and-click games to all sorts of stuff. Responsible.
You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
And go grab my socket wrench set from
the sort of mini games of putting the car together in this this game I really like.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with.
You deaf or just lazy?
You said her truck. Your socket wrench.
That's the 5/8 inch. I need the 13/16 inch extension, which is in the set, which is in the garage, like I said. Unbelievable.
I know that's not how they're portraying it. I'd like to believe Chloe did it knowing it was the wrong one just to annoy him.
Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay.
She's disgusted by the condoms. Now she's talking about his penis. That's hilarious.
What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something?
I mean, look. Oh, yeah, totally. Ashley Burch as Chloe in the original and then in Farewell is so good and is one of the best voice actresses out there. But having her be the writer of some of these episodes and not the voice actress, I think was actually cool, even though it was not supposed to happen that way. And they had to get another voice actress.
Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff? Asking for a friend. Should fill this with gasoline just in case David's car ever catches on fire. Damn. The stereo used to be in Dad's workshop. I should hook it up in my room before garbage day.
I also like how they cast someone who... Yeah. Well, what I like is they cast someone for this Chloe who does sound, you know, a little bit like Ashley Burch, but... They just let her do her own interpretation rather than just try and imitate Ashley Burch, which would not have worked, because if you've ever played Ashley Burch's other games like Horizon Zero Dawn or Borderlands, she's a very distinct voice.
Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore?
Oi, dad stuff.
Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. This was the photo Mom took down from the living room.
It's a hilarious photo.
Guess we don't
photo.
Have room for it and David's mustache. David's lawnmower. Maybe Mom and I like our lawn the way it is.
Ever think of that? Dad's toolbox. He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted.
I mean, the jump in animation quality is insane. I love the look of this game.
50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this.
Chloe's facial animations in this game are fantastic.
Maybe 90-10.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you.
Hustle. Screw you, dickhead.
See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude.
He is right
is
about that.
Special.
Not about the attitude, David. But that she could be good at it.
All right.
Oh, man. I gotta keep trolling him. I can't help myself.
What the f-
How you do anything is how you do everything.
Creep.
Now I need a shower.
Terrorist fist bump. You must have learned that in Afghanistan. JK, JK.
Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one. But thanks.
Ready to roll?
I need to turn off the vibrations. I don't know. This game does not need controller vibrations.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Oh boy, you ready for this, man? I am about to shut this shit down.
Respect him? I think it's time I show this asshole I'm not interested in anything.
Okay, I think I can beat this challenge.
What's clear is fuck you.
Language. You are way out of line, young lady.
Language? I'm sorry. I can't take you seriously.
That was probably
that
wrong,
mustache.
But I had to try it.
You're so smart. Too bad you don't know who you're dealing with here. That's enough. I won't stand for your
disrespectful
mouth.
Sorry, dude.
Regard for authority unites us, gives us dignity, and we are better united.
I forgot it was timed.
Than divided. Joyce, your mother.
I've seen the shutdown before, though, so I don't really care. And I'm gonna nail him with the weed thing later.
No doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use. It's making everything harder.
And honestly, it's not totally out of character that you would just be exhausted at this point, you know?
Get your act together and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes
sense? Yeah, it's true. I mean, getting the introspectiveness is kind of interesting here.
You don't know how lucky you
also,
are.
Also, me as
an
angsty teenager,
she's
I would mostly just say nothing in these
woman.
Situations.
Coddles you. It's true. But
parents just need to get stuff off their chest
you.
As messed up as
problem
it is.
Problem is, you don't learn discipline that way. Give me one chance to show her how things could be, and you'll be singing a different tune. Mark my words.
Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh god. This game is merciless. Merciless.
I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend. Burning the midnight hole again. What a beautiful day.
Okay, so, man or woman, I don't know if you're man or woman, person, Firefly D, first of all, thanks for being on chat. I'm going to run this up until she gets to school and meets Rachel Amber, and then take a break and then come back with the Rachel Amber stuff. I will stay, oh, cool. So, you know, I think probably the most interesting extended bit of decision making in some ways is when they're in the principal's office. I know, right? I know. The whole time you're going, just stop. Really quickly though, is there a scenario where if you don't do the principal's right, the play actually gets canceled? Because I do not want that to happen.
I know what a spark plug does, jerkbot.
I guess Mom left her purse back here?
So that's gonna be the one part where I'm gonna semi-cheat based on my seeing Dudger and Jesse play and ensure that the play goes on, because the play is maybe my favorite part of this. And that was written all by Ashley Birch, who, you know, plays Chloe, used to play Chloe. And the Tempest stuff is just great.
If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn
okay,
the
cool.
off.
Well, if you think it's fair, then that's enough for me.
Dad, turn it up.
It has so many metaphors, but it's so creative and so funny that it could be super pretentious, and it never comes off that way to me. Oh no! Oh no! Ugh. But I have to imagine that writing the extended Tempest stuff was such a fun challenge for Ashley Birch.
Hey.
Who, by the way, Ashley Birch is an Emmy-winning writer on, like, Nickelodeon and other networks. She's, like, a big effing deal.
Whatever.
You're welcome.
Hello, Black Hell.
She's only 30. She was in Forbes's 30 under 30 list this past year for creative talent, which is pretty cool. Oh God, Elliot.
Hey,
ugh.
Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
It's true, you should see the other guy.
I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick.
Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
Let me think about this. Fuck no.
No way. I'd rather have my eyes gouged out with rusted forks.
Yeah, right. Me too, I guess.
All right. See you in Cam.
Yeah, for sure.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
Steph! Okay, so I absolutely love and adore the Dungeons and Dragons and stuff with Steph. So after I do a couple things here and get to Steph, that's where I'm going to, I'm gonna just, you know, briefly cut the episode and then start again in a little bit. But really quickly, how do you feel about Warren from the first game?
Victoria Chase. I'd rather vomit razor blades than talk to her.
Yeah, I think women, you know, in my limited experience, women have more mixed feelings about Warren than men, which is predictable. Did you get the ending in the first game where Victoria was there at the end?
Need my DVD for.
Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Yeah, but the notion that
the
fact that when you choose to warn Victoria that pushes her to do the opposite and she ends up as a hostage was a really cool writing decision, as twisted as it is.
You hang with the Vortex Club?
I mean, I'm technically not a member, but I am being courted.
I'm not sure
the club should be a collection of Blackwell elites. But instead, it's some anti-bullying, hand-holding kumbaya shit. Not when I'm a senior.
Wow, the Young Artist Award.
Oh, it's not a big deal or anything. Like, 100 people submitted work, and my photography won.
Congrats, I guess.
So the Beacon's putting me up on the front page of the lifestyle section. Who cares?
Wait, what about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
No question here. I didn't want something done malicious at all. I mean, if I knew, I would try and get her not in that situation. I'm just saying, from a purely writing standpoint, it was a really interesting move. Okay, I have to say we murdered a man.
It was a pretty normal night for us. A little music, a little dancing. We murdered a guy.
You are so funny. Oh, seriously, though. I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure.
Are you asking me, did I choose Bay or Bay? Or you know, my sort of ideology about the whole thing? Because it's complicated.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Ugh.
I'm sorry, Victoria. I didn't mean to be rude. You know, I finished the assignment. Want some help?
You? Help me?
Of course. That last problem was hard, right? If I'm remembering correctly, the answer was fluorine, uranium, carbon.
I mean, the first game doesn't really
uranium again.
Give you much of a moral choice.
Hey,
in a way,
thanks,
even
Gary.
Though they give you the choice,
no problem.
And I know it's like a 50-50 split, and I understand people who chose Chloe. From a moral ethical standpoint, it's almost impossible to justify sacrificing the entire town for Chloe, especially because Chloe not only gives Max permission to sacrifice her, but it almost begs Max to make that decision. So, I would say I am BAY, and also knowing that this is a piece of literature, I think that's how it should end. But I get BAE.
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyta's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
What about you?
It's funny. The title's actually a play on the song, Who's Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf?
And that's funny?
It is if you're the wolf.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
That's cool.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always
Oh, and
say
also
that.
Because she kills her
I
mom and a lot of other people who...
sorry,
I'm sorry,
Chloe.
Kills Chloe's mom and a lot of other
no
people she likes, despite all the crappy people with BAE.
I bet.
I don't need an objective marker in Life is Strange, people. Squeenix, ease up.
Steph and Mikey normally post up somewhere quiet in the courtyard.
Did you see the movie Donnie Darko? I think there's more I can do here. Yeah. The ending was bullshit, but there's almost no examples of games where you can truly make a meaningful decision more than two or three options once you get to the end of the game. So, in Donnie Darko, especially in the original cut, Donnie figures out that he has to sacrifice himself with even less evidence. So, because I compared the first one to Donnie Darko so much and it was so clearly influenced, I don't totally agree. I think Max and Chloe are smart enough to put it together, at least as a hypothesis.
Morning, Miss Grant.
Chloe, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today?
Science is all about discovery, Miss Grant. Guess you'll have to wait and see.
With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate.
Let's start burning those bridges.
Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good, but instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support. But apparently, our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Maybe in another 6 months, a new donor will come along with money for, I don't know, more lasers.
More lasers?
Do we have any lasers?
Sadly, no.
That is sad.
I never got the lasers thing. That's funny. This is where all the Rachel Ambler posters are gonna be.
I prefer to wake and bake. But hey, to each their own.
Okay, good night. Thanks for being on the stream.
But fire's so pretty. What the fuck is that supposed to mean? Students at Blackwell have this herd instinct to glom up into little groups, like sheep. And if you just want to be alone, you get labeled like some dangerous outsider. Just like any other prison. Except now the prison follows you wherever you go, thanks to social media. I can't believe Rachel posted a photo of the two of us together last night. Am I still an outsider if I'm hanging out with Rachel Ambler now? And what does it mean that
Rachel Ambler is so cool?
Awesome? Does that make me just the same as every other student here? Nah, fuck that.
Alright, let's go to Steph, and we will save the Dungeons & Dragons amazingness for session number 3. Okay. Man, these controls weird. Let's do a quick journal check before we get over there.
Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere.
Everyone's a nerd. Oh yeah, we're gonna talk to this dude. But we'll save this. Evan! Alright, people. I'll leave you with this great shot of Chloe Price. I will be back on later today for sure to continue this episode. Thank you so much for watching. I will be back at you soon.